गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ साइंस एंड इट्स नेम इज सॉइल इरोजन एंड कंजर्वेशन। लेट अस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डिस्कस व्हाट इज अ सॉइल। एज वी नो सॉइल अराउंड अस हैज रॉक पार्टिकल्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सैंड, सिल्ट, क्ले, पेबल्स, air, tiny living things and humus. Now, what is humus? Humus is formed from the remains of plants and animals. Humus makes our soil fertile.
Done.
surface becomes cracked, and after that wind and flowing water widen the crack, that means increase the gap between the rocks, and after that rock break into pieces, then gradually, slowly the rocks converted into sand, pebbles, silt and clay, and after some time plants also appeared on the earth's surface, and their plants finally mixed with the soil, and this is how the formation of our soil. Now our next heading is topsoil. What is topsoil? The topmost layer of the soil is called topsoil. As we have seen that how the soil was formed. Now topsoil means the uppermost, the topmost layer of the soil is called topsoil. Topsoil is essential for the growth of plants because it contains the nutrients required by the plants. Nutrients make the soil fertile. Nutrients make the soil fertile and it intensify the development and growth of plants and trees much better. Now we will start soil erosion. Any process that damages or removes the topsoil from a region causes soil erosion. Or we can say the removal of topsoil from one place to another due to the wind or water is known as soil erosion. Soil erosion makes the soil less fertile. Soil erosion due to the removal of topsoil from one place to the another place because of wind or water. The topsoil moves from one place to another, it decreases the fertility of the soil. It makes our soil less fertile. The natural causes of soil erosion are wind and flowing water. These are two natural causes of soil erosion. Let us see what happens due to the less fertility of the soil. Due to the decrease in the fertility of the soil, the land becomes barren. And what happens in that type of land? Land does not have plants. Barren lands get eroded at a faster rate. Barren land gets eroded at a faster rate. Let us see how it happens. Because when there will be no plants, no vegetation in that particular land, particular area, then the soil will be loose. The topmost soil will be loose and the wind or the water can easily flow or move that topsoil from one place to another place, and that land becomes barren. So barren land then eroded very easily because there is no plant, no vegetation. So we conclude from this that plants bind the soil. Plants or vegetation bind the soil and prevent the process of soil erosion. Our next heading is deforestation. What is the meaning of deforestation? Cutting down of a tree on a large scale is called deforestation. What is the need for the cutting of trees or cutting down of forest? As the population is increasing, to fulfill the basic requirements, we are cutting the trees from the forest for growing crops, mining, building roads, and for obtaining wood. We are continuously cutting the trees, cutting the forest, and this makes the that area barren. Due to this, the land exposed to wind and flowing water. When there will be no tree, then the land will be exposed to wind and flowing water. Means wind and water can easily remove the topsoil from one place to another place, and there will be condition of soil erosion. Thus, we can say that deforestation leads to soil erosion. Let us see one more cause of soil erosion, that is overgrazing. What happens in overgrazing? The cattle feed the plants, eat the grasses that are in the field. When the cattle eat the grasses in a very large amount, then the field is said to be overgrazed. So overgrazing by cattle leads to the destruction of plants. It makes the land barren. When the cover crop is eaten by the cattle, then the land becomes barren. Natural cover of the plant is lost. What is mean by the word natural cover? When farmer harvest the crop, then there is a time gap between harvesting of one crop and the sowing of another crop. So farmers sow some grasses or pulses for some time, so that these grasses and pulses bind the soil and prevent the soil erosion. But when cattle eat the grasses and these pulses, then the land loses the natural cover. And what happens? Land becomes exposed to wind and flowing water. After that, the land is free, the soil is loose, and it can be easily move away from one place to another by wind or flowing water. And finally, it leads to the condition of soil erosion. So overgrazing is one of the factors that causes soil erosion. Next topic is soil conservation. Prevention of soil erosion is called soil conservation. Conservation means to conserve, to protect our topsoil from being eroded, to protect our topsoil to move from one place to another due to the rain or the flowing water is soil conservation. So simply we can say soil conservation means protection of our topsoil. Now let us see what are steps to conserve soil. Some are given here. First one is growing of plants. Second is afforestation and reforestation. Third one is carrot farming or step farming. Fourth one is building burrows. Next is cover crops. And last one is shelter beds. Now we will see the uses of these one, how to apply these one by one. Let us first of see growing of plants. Growing of plants. Now let us first of all discuss the first one is growing of plants. To prevent soil erosion, barren land should be covered with a variety of plants. We should grow more and more trees in barren land to prevent soil erosion, because the roots of the plant firmly binds the soil particles and prevent the loss of soil due to the force of wind or flowing water. So this point means growing of plants means to grow more and more trees in that area to prevent soil erosion. Second is afforestation and reforestation. Afforestation and reforestation. Afforestation. Planting of trees is called afforestation. Afforestation is the process of planting trees on barren land to grow more trees, more plants is deforestation, and it is done to conserve the soil, to protect the soil. And what is reforestation? Reforestation is a systematic attempt to revive a damaged forest region. In afforestation, we make a new forest region. In afforestation, we make a new forest region by planting more and more trees. But in reforestation, a systematic, we make a process to revive a damaged forest region. A forest region which is damaged, we plant again to revive that damaged forest region. The next thing is terrace farming or step farming. Next one is terrace or step farming. Terrace or step farming is done on hills. In this, the farmers cut the hills into steps. What is the reason behind it? Because on the hill there is a slope, and when water comes with a force, then it moves the topmost soil, fertile soil, from one place to another place, and the particular area will become barren. So the farmers cut the hills into steps, and these steps help to stop the soil in a particular place, and by this we can reduce the force of the water by which we can protect the soil from moving from one place to another. So this is also known as terrace farming or step farming, because in this steps are also made. The next one is building of burns. During the rainy seasons, the river gets a fresh supply of water, and due to this, the water level in the river increases, and this water comes to the nearby farmlands and can damage the particular area and cause soil erosion. So we make some area around the river that stop the force of water and prevent the soil erosion. Next is cover crops. After each crop, there is a period when a farmland is barren. After harvesting of a crop, there is a time gap, there is certain time period when a farmland, when the area remains free, means barren. There is no another crop. What happens in that case? In that case, it will be exposed to sunlight, and due to this the soil will become dry and the soil will become loosened, and then the wind and water can easily move the soil from one place to another place, and in this case soil erosion occurs and the soil, topmost soil, eroded, and that land becomes completely barren and there will be no chance for the another crops to grow. So what happens in this case? What farmers do to protect the soil? Farmers therefore grow a crop to cover that area, like some types of grasses and pulses. These are grown by farmers to cover the crop, and therefore these crops are known as cover crops. Examples are some grasses and pulses, and cover crops are mostly as cattle feed. Next one is shelter beds. A farmland which is open from all sides, the area which is open from all sides is exposed to the force of wind and flowing water. If the area will be open from all sides, then obviously it will be exposed to force of wind and flowing water, means wind and water can easily remove the topsoil from that place. So in this case, the farmers grow trees, shrubs and grasses on the boundaries to protect the soil, to reduce the force of wind and flowing water. This is known as shelter belt. Thank you.